What's up, guys, and welcome to what can only really be described as the best team to use this December for the 3v3 Dynamax meta. This is a variant of the team I've been using throughout this week, and I did some edits, and those edits are based on, well, first and foremost, Hitmonlee in this team did not make sense, and Magnezone, for example, didn't, while it did good, there are Pokemon that does a lot better in the rain. One of those are Scizor. So the short review here is that we got Belipper, a very, very aggressive one with Expert Belt. It's modest, at outspeed, everything, unless, you know, Choice Dragapult and whatnot, which will not be in this meta. How about that? And Hydro Pump, Kid Rain, Ice Beam, Rain Dance, it is good. It is a nice mod to have, I really like it. To get away, of course, Pelipper. Now I changed Pelipper for the ones I had, which was speedy, to a more defensive one, mainly to be able to stop other setters. Phenomenal, or one of those Pokemon stands out that deals with Pelipper rather well is actually Gigalith. Other one is Ninetales that could stop it. So being more defensive means that you can stand against them and punish them. Hurricane Skull, U-turn Roost is plenty. The reason I go for Skull over Hydro Pump is because Hurricane hits harder anyway, and even if the Hydro Pump is boosted by the rain, I feel Hurricane is just much, much more reliable, and always getting a Skull Burn or something is quite nice. Kingdra is the Eject Button variant, or Eject Pack. Basically, this set allows you to do two things. It lets you go for the high damage output with Flip Turn, and lets you go for Hydro Pump, Hurricane. But more so, if you're unsure and want to just nuke something, you're able to go for Draco Meteor without being punished by it. So you get switched out if it's just a wrong call. And even after Dynamax, like getting the Hurricane so you can have a plus speed and then get Draco Meteor to get out of there, it's a phenomenal tool. And I've been very glad to have it. And basically, have rarely been a reason not to Draco because the risk of losing special attack has not been there. So I highly recommend this set. The specs variant, yes, it's good, and the specs version actually beats this Kingdra, so watch out for that. But other than that, there are no drawbacks to Draco Meteor, and that's always a good thing. Then we have Scizor, a special defensive one with a max attack. It has Bullet Punch, U-turn, Super Power, and Sword Stance. This set beats Ferrothorns. It also beats the majority of the most effective mods in the meta. It does struggle versus opposing rain teams, but it's kind of supposed to. Luckily, with a special or with the defense investment being born with this, you are able to set up a Soul Stance and really, really pressure your mods. One thing that should be noted is you don't get Roost this generation, or get Roost, but not through Generation 8. So Soul Stance is really our only source of actually attacking, and Akabar is there to avoid the worst. If you have a Sun team, you're able to stomach at least one Fire Blast, and it does alright. It's not best, it's not the best thing out there, but it does deal with certain matchup quite well. And then we have Dreadnought. Now Dreadnought here is not the G-Max variant. It's basically because it's Max G-Max, like Rock, Splinter Rock, something like that. It is a water move that sets up Stealth Rocks. We want to be able to set up our own rain, so we're actually gonna go with the regular Dreadnought, so the rain, or the Max Max Geisha, yeah, is doing what it's supposed to. Head Smash do get you out of it though. It sets a Soul Stance up, or I mean Sandstorm up, so watch out for that. An Earthquake is a decent filler. Sugarberry is there for one thing, and that is to freely be able to set up Soul Stance versus potential Shecks. I was considered Life Orb, but it was considered Choice Band at a time, but Sugarberry has come clutch more times than you expect to, and it's because you can stay in against matchup that are supposed to beat it because they get their free Earthquake, and it's not going to be enough, and you will be able to retaliate or even Dynamax and punish them heavily after Sword Stance. And then the last Pokemon, which is Rotom Wash, which for rain team doesn't make sense, but it is individually really, really, really strong. And Overheat is awesome. This is, of course, a Pokemon that you gotta Dynamax if you want to use it properly. But Overheat, Thunderbolt, decent stabs. Nasty Plot to be able to capitalize on your Gimax form. And Dark Pulse is there to lower the special defense of the opposing Pokemon if you're Dynamaxing. I was considering going for Scoff to get it with Trick. But quite frankly, the Passive Berry to be able to stain versus water types and retaliate against them, it is just up there as one of the best things to absolutely use with Rotom Wash. And overall, There is a certain issue with some teams with this team, but Roden Ward can abuse that against them, and that's something to keep in mind. And overall, there aren't really that many mods that deals with these guys head on. The damage output is quite high, and with Pokemon such as Magnezone gone through the meta, you can't use it in September. It makes sense to allow Scissor to kind of work in and get its way in there. Another mod that stands out, which I think is great, it's gonna be very viable, which this team deals with somewhat well, is the Covenite. Covenite do not stop Rotom. It barely stops Pelipper. So Corviknight will be somewhat common together with the Horse Slowbro and Among Us. And what do you know, Rotom Wash, Rotom Heat, I mean, beats them to the pulp, but with Nasty Plot it just gets that much better. And this team, of course, is synergized well enough to beat opposing Rotom Heats. And against a Rotom Heat, you face it, you can always Dark Pulse it and lower its special defense and punish it to get out. So, I don't know, I like this team. I think this is going to be probably one of the stronger team combinations throughout September. There could be absolutely better teams, and it's not like this is the ideal best team out there, but there are very few teams that have a synergy that beats most matchup. But as always, watch out for Dracovish. It clearly punishes this team because of the Fishes Rend, and Kingdra do not enjoy taking them, so it's worth mentioning. But on that, I really hope you guys enjoyed these, and of course, a small showcase of what can happen with this team. So without further ado, thank you for watching and enjoy this following video. Alright, what's up guys? As always, welcome back to another OU battle, which is truly this calendar. And I am using absolutely an OU team this time. I wanted to create something different, but due to time crunches basically, I just set an old rain team together with some new ideas. And basically see how that one goes. And this looks like to be a good team though. Look at this. The synergy is so great. Really like Mudsdale here from Pyro. I really like Lapras. And then, you know, we got Cinderace, so theoretically this is an Uber battle, but at the same time, I do recognize his Lapras can potentially just sweep my team really, really easily. But I think I have a good lead, or he just completely drops.